Welcome to the 9th video in the Real Evolution FileMaker video series.
In FileMaker, scripts allow you to automate tedious or complex tasks and perform them automatically based on a trigger. In many ways, FileMaker scripts are similar to VB scripts or Apple scripts. This video will provide an overview of the basics of using scripts in FileMaker to make your life easier. We'll conclude the video by looking at a practical example of using scripts to determine the total amount of outstanding payments due. This video will consist of four sections. Firstly, the uses of scripts. Secondly, script maker and script steps. Thirdly, running scripts. And finally, a practical example. There are an almost infinite number of uses for scripts in FileMaker. Often scripts are used to organize layouts, perform calculations across multiple records, manipulate data, or manage usability. For instance, a reseller might write a script to send payment requests to all customers whose accounts are more than 30 days overdue. This same reseller might use a script to automatically sort their customer table in ascending order. Alternatively, a script could be used to flag all customers whose orders have exceeded $50,000 in the most recent month. The same script could then apply a discount rate to these customers. The possibilities are endless. The main thing to remember about FileMaker scripts is that they exist to make your life easier. So if you find yourself doing the same thing over and over again, chances are you should be using a script. The script maker can be accessed from the scripts menu. FileMaker will then present you with the Manage Scripts window. From here, click New to create a new script, and you'll be asked to enter the script name. Enter a memorable name and click OK. The Edit Script window will then appear. The Edit Script window consists of two main parts, script steps on the left and your script on the right-hand side. Unlike other scripting languages, scripts in FileMaker are a drag-and-drop affair, so script steps must be dragged from the menu on the left into the script composition area. Other options in the window allow you to check compatibility with previous versions of FileMaker, and select script options and access privileges. Script steps are commands that are executed when your script is run. There are a variety of types of script steps, such as steps which relate to navigation, such as changing layouts, steps which relate to records, editing, windows, files, and so on. To demonstrate the process of creating a script, we'll create a simple script that goes to the customer's layout and sorts the records by surname in ascending order. To do this, select the Go to Layout step from the Script Steps list, choose the Customer's Layout in the pop-up menu, add the Sort Script step and choose the Surname field and stipulate an ascending direction, close the script window and save your script. To run your script, click the Perform button. It's important to remember that the context in which your script runs is conferred by the currently open layout. In the previous example, we told the script to change to the customer's layout. If we hadn't done this, however, the script would have tried to sort records in the currently open layout based on the surname field. Context becomes extremely important if a script edits, deletes, or creates records. Scripts can be run manually from the Scripts menu or the Manage Scripts windows, or alternatively, you can set up FileMaker to run scripts based on a trigger. FileMaker allows you to run selected scripts directly from the Scripts menu. To include a script in this menu, select the checkbox beside it in the Manage Scripts window. Conversely, script triggers can be set up to run scripts based on a timer, layout events, or layout object events. Layout objects include elements such as buttons and text fields. To access layout script triggers, enter the Layout Setup window by selecting Layout Setup from the Layout menu and click on the Script Triggers tab. You can specify a script to run for a variety of events, such as an OnRecordLoad event, by selecting the event and clicking on the Select button in the Script Trigger Properties group. The process for attaching scripts to layout object events is very similar. Enter the Edit Layout mode and select an object. Then select Format, Set Script Triggers, and the window will allow you to attach scripts to events. The example we'll look at today will determine the total amount of outstanding payments due to our hypothetical reseller business. To do this, the script will enumerate every record in the invoices layout, add the outstanding balance of the invoice to a variable, and finally, display the variable to the user. Thanks for watching this installment of the Real Evolution FileMaker video series. We hope to see you again soon.